That's my general's unit. Your army has been misled by an agent of the enemy. He has escaped undetected on this occasion. Confederation of the Rhine. Although nominally independent states, the German lands along the eastern banks of the River Rhine are but mere pawns of the so-called Republic of France. Their lords bend the knee to the Grand Emperor and kiss his boots like any other of his lackeys. There's no time for diplomatic bean counting. In this great war, you stand either with us or against us. They have chosen. We must, in all aspects, regard these territories as French possessions. Can't really blame them, can you? So the Ottomans and the Austrians are at war. Recruitment. Yeah, it's got the light dragoons in Gibraltar. I thought it would help sort of boost the range of the raiding path and keep those sort of to any other towns down from developing. Just by raiding them every so often. So the two merchantmen have finished. It says, pity I can't get any Indiamen, but I'll have to make do with merchantmen for now. Right, so that's fine.
Yes, my lord.
Yeah, I'm getting that. That's what I told you to do last turn. So I've got... What do I have here? So I've got a merchantman there. Now, on the tricks. Oh, where are you going? Where are you? Are they going up there? Well, no, they're coming back down here. Why has he not raided my merchant ships? But I mean, how on earth have he managed to get his ships through my lines? Le Havre hasn't been... No, it's Brest, not Le Havre. So Brest hasn't been replaced. Hasn't been rebuilt. So that's not its buildings repaired. Neither has Le Havre, so I was right in the first time. That still has no building at Calais. Right, he's just done the trading port there. And he's got this one repaired as well. It's got two trading ports, one Batavian. What are the Danes? What's Denmark doing with those vessels? The Netherlands, well, it's effectively Batavian Republic, I suppose, but it's the Netherlands. What did they manage to get? India, man? Oof. It's one heck of a size. Alright, you can panic now, because I don't know where the... Oh. Wait a minute, where have the French gone? Wherever they have gone, this is now clear. There's no red line attaching it to the actual main trade line. King of Portugal... Spain 1260, but I'm above it, he's 510. I've got two red lines just there, which is obvious because that's Cartagena. And that trade line must be going to here. 3976, crikey. Three vessels here of the French Navy has he split the fleet up? Why is he not? Interesting. Is that coming down? That's up to 704 now. Alright. Let's get these merchants that are messing around. So occupy the pop those there for
orders now. Received and understood.
I'm bring these ones out to combine these together.
Any orders? Aye, aye, sir.
Yeah, so these aren't exactly armed, but they can defend themselves, but nothing against, not against warships.
Yes, my lord.
Light sort of sloops or brigs or even a frigate.
Orders received and understood.
I'll occupy this. If I can. I don't know where the French have disappeared to, though. But that is a nice, juicy target just there. But I don't know what he's got.
Ship's orders.
So what do we get? 962. So that's 1,924 of these two combined. So he's just gone up 900 and... nearly 4,000. That's okay. So what do we actually have here with military units? Lightfoot, I don't really need Lightfoot. Foot line infantry. I'd rather have militia. Because militia have yeah, they have bonuses when it comes to policing. I believe they should do anyway. Defensibles. Yeah, garrison policing bonus. So I'm going to recruit that. Once that's recruited, I'm going to disband the line infantry. There's no point spending money on things I'm not going to use. Not yet, anyway. Nothing's been finished, obviously. Nothing I'd want to go. Yeah, I've got militia just there, so they've already got the policing bonus in place. Cool. I'd like to take that Batavian Republic fleet apart. So I've got no lines off here towards the French coast. Yeah, there's no building. I don't know where. Like I said, I don't know where the French fleet has disappeared to. They could just be lurking off here. They could be anywhere. So I'm going to go and look for them. I don't know where the
ready.
Spanish fleet have gone either.
Weigh anchor.
I think if they'd combined together,
ready and
I
waiting.
Think I'd know it by now.
Haul away. Ship's orders.
It's going to skip come past about. Here. Let's see what's like the Spanish trade point.
Any orders?
A Spanish fleet. I have no idea what the Spanish fleet is consisting of.
Orders, Captain!
But it's the only target that's actually valid. La Coruna. I don't know where the Spanish deep. I don't know where the Spanish fleet's gone. All the French fleet's gone. Where's the French gone? Alright, take these out.
They shall sleep with the fishes.
Oh, good grief, they overkill our what? 24 gun corvette. 12 gun merchantman. Oh, crikey. Oh well. There is no way I stand up to this. Let's hope it doesn't reduce my movement points down so I don't get to attack these, because these I need to take out. Shouldn't do, but you never know. That's an overkill. Found something else I have actually done after actually taking a look at some naval sort of research documents. Well, some sort of historically so-called accurate or probably called research sort of material. Actually increase the length, sorry not the length, the actual range of chain shot on your attacks and damages sails, but they used to open up a battle with that, especially during this time period. It wasn't very accurate, but you could still use it at those ranges. It just wasn't as accurate as solid shot, but you could still open the battle up with it. Grape shot, obviously you couldn't, because that's more like a grape shot used in shotguns, anti-personnel. That's enough talking, let's get going. Wow, it's coming from the side. Try and tack into the wind. And the size of these ships that I've got, they're not very good sailors. As you can tell. Light breeze by the look at the wind indicator here. doesn't help. That's one hell of a size ship though. I mean, crikey. How many of these things wouldn't be coming towards us? There'd be one in a way. Being left behind by the Corvette. See if that switch to change shop. It is the same range, but it's not as effective at long range. Obviously, grape shot is much closer. We want to capture these ships. There's a problem with boarding, and it's a stock game book, it's part of the hard code, so there's nothing you can do about it. And it's when a vessel is wavering and you try to board it and it surrenders between the beginning and the end of the boarding animation, and it will crash your game, it will just lock up. So it's best if you want to board, capture ship through boarding actually, it's best if you do it straight from the beginning. Do, I mean, there's no way they've got that many men. I've got 347 on the first, on the upper first rate. 147 on the fifth, is that the fourth? Yeah, it's the fourth rate. 307 on the second rate, no, first rate. 283. That's actual fighting personnel as well. Something else I've done, I actually increased the size of the crews on each vessel, so it makes it a little bit more realistic. Whilst your first rate historic would have had over 800 men. Most of them would have been gunners. Turning, just going around. What on earth is she going to try to? She's going to try and attack this fleet, surely. It looks like it. Yeah, it's got longer range. Lighter guns, longer range. Nah, I don't think so, man. Heavier the gun, less range, which isn't technically historically accurate either, but you have to have some balance. She's attacking the flagship. What is second rate? No, fourth rate. No, it's a first rate. Good grief, you're in for a world of hurt. live on chain shocks. I'm going to try and damage the sail, because that's the only advantage they've got, is their speed. Side. To attack a fleet this size. Well, I could have started running. Turn around. Swing around and cripple the two merchantmen's fleet sails. Already. Superior local force. I don't know where you're looking. She's shaken. So now if I try to board her and she has got some shaken to surrender, somewhere between the beginning and the end of the animation for boarding, it will just clock the game up. Oh dear. It's two masts she's lost. Three masts and four masts. Now what you're gonna do. Alright, so you anchor. Separate them out. Concentrate on that one. Just surrender. You move to Enterprise and then surrender. I mean, two merchant ships and a... It's got two merchant ships which I can take and use myself. Or I can make some money, fortune, and that. That's not no point, is it? That. Can't really use that. Not bothered. Those two. Definitely. I didn't take too much damage either, even though it shows a tattered Union Jack. I don't know, you know, not that much damage. Okay, so this is late January 1798. We'll continue onward.
Yes, Your Majesty.
I'm going to send these two vessels, though. Oops, there's a bit of a jump there. Send these two vessels. Can I build something there? Well, I can, but I'll send them here instead for repairs.
Set sail! Jump to it and look lightly!
Tap the space bar. Then, oh, tap the space bar before land.
Ship's orders, Captain!
Naval. Call, and then we'll repair them. Scupper? No, I don't want. Repair. Cost zero. So I didn't need repairing. But one of them should display 12. It must be damaged. So that's two more merchants,
yes, my
I don't
lord.
Need to actually build. But I'll build another two.
The sea will be their grave!
That's wishful thinking. I bet they've got quite a large fleet here. Ah, interesting. A single 74 gunship of that, the Royal Navy would term as a third rate. I've only got one of those. Everything else is bigger than that. Except the fourth rate, obviously. Actually, no, the fourth rate is smaller than that, isn't it? It's fourth rate, not a third rate. 32 gun. So, gone 32 gun. One brig. And the rest of my trade ships. If I can capture those Indiamen. Oh boy, oh boy, oh boy. That saved me from having to build 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 Indiamen. But they are heavily armed. Look, for merchants, they're heavily armed anyway. How good is he? Don't know. Jan Hendrik van Kingsbergen. Why am I always deploying second when I'm the one attacking? Deploys first and he deploys second. A little bit on men, but not that much. More than a match from these. But the real worry is where's the Spanish fleet and where's the French fleet? I can do this all day long, but if they combine together and attack somewhere, there's no way I can stop them. Not right now. But we take victories where we can. von Kingsbergen. What have you got?